We're back, but this time we're in full glorious color and even wider screen for your viewing pleasure. Welcome back, folks. This is the Cadillac Bill Show.
Okay, we are back, and the reason we're back is basically because I feel that I have a lot more to say about Hamilton, and more importantly than that, Hamilton's got more to say. I feel that Hamilton is nothing more than a huge giant iceberg floating in the ocean, and what we see about Hamilton is the tip of the iceberg. The majority of Hamilton is underwater, and that's what Hamilton's all about. It's a city submerged under the water, and we are really going to try to show you guys what really goes on in this city. And by the way, ladies and gentlemen, I want to introduce to you a new member of the Creeping Bent Orchestra. Here it is, or here he is. This gentleman's name is Mr. Vomit.
The Clan Vomit.
Welcome to the show. Dan, get a good close-up of Frankie Vomit here. Frankie Vomit here was picked out of millions to be the Creeping Bent Orchestra guitarist.
He had the look, the perfect look.
He did, he really did. And that's not eyeliner. And now, of course, Danny Koltoff, you guys will remember him. And then Shane Sharp now has his own light on him, so he's no longer in the dark. Here, lift your head up a bit just so we can, there you go. For your enjoyment, you can now see Shane full widescreen.
Bomb rocking.
Yeah. So basically, we are going to now start off with something that I want you guys to know about Hamilton. Hamilton apparently is the waterfall capital of the world, which means we have the most waterfalls in the world.
And the best. Best waterfalls ever.
Well,
in the history of waterfalls.
Well, let's not get too out of hand here. We got some pretty good waterfalls. So I wanted to start off this season with showing Hamilton in its full glory. And Chaos Divine, the CBS show dancer, is going to help make those waterfalls even more beautiful. So let's right now check out Hamilton's waterfalls. Here we go.
Thank you.
All right.
So, amazing.
Yeah, beautiful
water. She knows how to move water.
She really makes those waterfalls look good. And by the way, that I think Chaos and I spent more time doing that segment than I've done in any other of our Cadillac Doll Show segments. Huh? Took us 2 days to film all that.
My goodness.
Yeah, I mean, like for a little 3.5 minute film.
Excellent.
We were hiking. You have to first find these waterfalls, and then we had to like hike literally for half an hour.
Oh, I thought you were going to say 3 days.
Well,
it was cold. Did you see any wild animals, Bill?
No, we didn't see any wild animals, Dan. But good question. By the way, I also wanted to say that Hamilton really represents any city in the world. Every city in the world has something cool about it, stuff going on under the tip of that iceberg, what we are delving into, the seedy underbelly. And Hamilton just really represents every city. But your city doesn't have beautiful waterfalls. I can tell you that for sure. So we're going to cut for a commercial break now. And we are going to basically be back in a minute. So don't go away. We'll be right back after this break.
Thank you. It's nice. Yeah. Bill, I didn't know we had commercials on the show.
Well, I don't know if we do either, but...
Because I had it really planned for Bill to start talking to me, and I was going to go, hold on a second, Ice Cube Shay?
Yes, please.
Who's going to stop all the whiskey? Oh. Nice to help.
Here, there's the other one bottle here.
I'll have the gin.
You'll have the gin?
No.
What kind of gin?
Gilbert's.
No. What kind of whiskey?
Tanqueray.
Hey, you want to pass them the, There we go. There we go.
Oh my.
Okay, how much minutes has it been, Dan?
About a minute.
We've done a minute. Okay, guys.
First positions.
All right. Hang on a minute.
Do you mind?
Yeah, give me a second.
Okay.
Is there a phone ringing or is it just me?
I think it's his alarm.
What's that noise? Oh, yes. Okay, so Dan, we've now got a one... We're out of town. All right.
Hold on.
Okay. Welcome back to the Cadillac Bill Show. First episode of season one.
Season one?
No. Correct. Season two. And, of course, our new member of the show... says Frank Vomit. He's replaced Mike Williams, who quit the outfit, and we're deeply honored and grateful to have Frank Vomit here with us.
Hello.
And by the way, Frank Vomit has other skills. Who here knows what a prestidigitator is?
Not sure of that.
It's not like a masturbator, is it, Bill?
Thank you for your little classy input there, Cold Dog. No. Do you know what a prestidigitator is?
I don't actually, Bill.
Do you know what one is?
I don't, Bill.
You don't?
Thank you.
I thought you knew everything.
You thought I knew what a prestidigitator
was. I assume you knew what a prestidigitator was. Frank Vomit here is a prestidigitator. That means he's a magician.
Oh!
Can you do a little something? Or
okay,
is it...
here. I'll grab this from you over here. And, I think I can use this one. So you'll take this and I'll just put it here, give it a couple knocks and... It's gone from my hand,
that's cool.
All the way into my pocket here, and then I can take it from here, give it a couple spins, and then I got two. All right, there's a reason why I need two, Bill. I'm gonna show you really quick, right? I'm gonna take this one here, put it in this hand, and I'm gonna give you this one to hold on to, okay? Now just close your hand around mine, that's perfect. Now I'm just gonna go like this, my hand, your hand. It's gone from my hand, you got both.
Good.
It hardly seems possible.
It's almost like a miracle. It's almost like you're sort of godlike, eh?
Kinda.
It's literally like having a messiah here amongst us.
Just like Jesus.
Good stuff.
Jesus.
That's like Jesus. Yeah, really. Hey, that's pretty cool. Help yourself to a drink.
Ice Cube Shane?
Also, people, I wanted to say that we now have an addition to the set. A fully stocked bar just to make us more classy, and more inviting for you at your homes. And I also wanted to say that we have a wonderful little segment. This is kind of in conjunction with the waterfalls. This is the nature stuff of the of Hamilton, where we all went off. Well, Mike and I went off to the Kilman Zoo. We all went on a little expedition.
We barely made it back.
Yeah, it was some hair-raising stuff. So we're going to share this all with you all now as the CBS Safari Expedition team to the Kilman Zoo. And right in there. Hello, this is Cadillac Bill. I'm right now in an area of Hamilton very few of you ever see. This is one of the deepest, darkest outbacks of Hamilton, filled with vicious animals, wildlife, stuff that you don't want to encounter if you're unprepared. Now, we're prepared. We've got all of the attire needed for wildlife that could be man-eaters. Plus, we are skilled. We know how the animals think. Here's the CBS team, Safari Expedition team. This is Jana. Hey, Jana, are you ready for this?
I sure am ready, Bill. And you know what? I hope we're going to see a lot of animals. And we're going to shoot them first with this. But in case we run into any trouble, we've got this.
Good stuff, Jana. Excellent. Good to have you on board. And then we've got little Xanthi here. This is Mike Holler's daughter. That was Mike Holler's wife. Hey, Xanthi, are you ready for this? Some vicious tigers here. So we're right now in Hamilton's outback. Some real live tigers, I think. But not only that, we've got some experts here who might even let us know what the heck are these things.
These are lions, lion cubs.
Yeah, those are little guys, are they?
Yeah.
Okay, it's very important, kids. If you're ever in this situation, you're surrounded by vicious animals. Very important to have these metal fences between you and the animals. It's one of your best defenses against wild critters. So yeah, tell me about these big cats.
Well, everyone's a little on edge right now as the new lions have arrived. Their parents, as you can see, are stalking them because they don't recognize them as their babies. They're just a small moving cat invading their territory. So all our tigers and lions are a little edgy right now. They all would like a little snack.
So you figure the parent lions would eat these ones if they could?
Yes, because they've been separated from them so long, they don't recognize that they're their cubs.
Just like people, really, isn't it?
Just like people.
You know, a lot of people think dogs are bigger than cats, but people forgetting that actually house cats are about the smallest cat in the world. Cats as a species are much bigger than dogs. Like the largest cat's about 3 times bigger than the largest dog, isn't it?
Oh yes, the largest cat in the world is a Siberian tiger.
And how many pounds would one of those be?
Our male is about 700 pounds.
Look at that.
That's a bobcat, I think.
I think you might be right. Look at those ears. Hey, Paige, what is that thing?
A Eurasian lynx.
Oh, okay. You were almost right there, Xanthi.
Same family.
Hey, little fella. Now, these are wild boars.
No, they're actually peccaries.
From where? Where are they from?
South America.
South America, right? You name them.
Piglet and Wilbur.
Piglet and Wilbur.
What have we here?
This is a Bennett's wallaby. He's very friendly, but you can see how big his thighs are. His back legs are quite powerful, and if he were ever to get loose, he would be gone in seconds. This is just a big muscle, so if he wanted to, he could lean back on it and jump forward or sit on it.
Right.
And that's why we hold him by the tail. It doesn't hurt him because it's just a muscle, and it's the safest way to hold them.
And would this make a good pet?
No, he poops a lot.
We'll be right back. Do any of these other ones talk? Well, not that that one was talking, but...
That's Mama. She seems to be the most vocal of all the sheep here.
Hey, what's your tattoo say?
Out of suffering have emerged the strongest souls. The most massive characters are seared with scars.
You're probably about the coolest zookeeper in the world, eh? Hold it. Hold it. Just a sec. I think I see something in the distance. Yeah, there's a deer over there, far away. Good thing I got these high-powered binoculars. Such a majestic-looking creature, eh, out there in the wilderness. Look at that. Boy, she looks closer than she actually is. And look, check this out. Check this out. You don't see this very often every day, eh? What are those, Zant?
Chickens.
Yeah, you ever seen a chicken before?
Yes.
I didn't think so. Me neither. Look at that. Those are very special. Where'd you get those from? Like somewhere like Nairobi or Burma?
Actually, she came from the feed store as a chick. We ordered her from the feed store as a chick, the red one. Her name's Henny Penny.
So if you ever need a chicken, you have to go to Burma, find the feed store in Burma, and ask around, and you may be able to get yourself something very exotic, like one of these things. Okay. Oh, hey, look at this. Over here, we got to check this out. I've just spotted something you don't see very often. Very rare.
Let's have a look, though.
Look at this. In the wild. In the wild, a cat in the wild. See, that's...
I recommend you probably approach with caution. I think you should probably have Jana take a quick look at
it. Okay, Jana, check it out. Look at that.
Careful, careful.
You don't see this kind of thing in Hamilton, that's for sure. It's so beautiful. It's so majestic. Hey, now what kind of cat is this?
He's a zoo cat.
A zoo cat?
Yes.
Is that the Latin word for it or what?
I'm not sure what the Latin word is, but his name is Pickles.
Pickles. And how many of them are these pickle species left in the wild, would you say?
There's only three here.
Yeah.
So
they're pretty endangered, eh?
Yeah.
So what a true thrill. What an amazing sight we have. One of only three left in the wild or in the Kilman Zoo. Pickles. So we've got a little surprise, a little treat for the big cats. We want to basically appease them and offer them up something delicious for a change, something they're not used to. So I'm going to make this little pie for the big cat. And this is the Smiths album. There we go. So look at this, a salmon head. We're gonna make a little, try to grab that thing in there. There we go. The cats are gonna love this. Jana, you wanna make a little bow tie out of that?
That's Xanthi.
I mean Xanthi. And we got two legs. There we go. Does it look like a little guy? I'd love it. How are you coming along with the bow tie there?
Gonna be the best looking baloney bow tie ever.
Okay, so yes, you do. You put that right on him. Right on him. I think his name
okay.
is gonna be.
It's more like a bib, but.
Meter.
Okay.
Peter.
Meter.
Okay, so here we go.
Excellent.
Okay, let's throw it over to the turkey right now. Let's see if the turkey's interesting. There we go. Okay, so Xanthi, you're now gonna give this to the tiger. So now you carry that, and you're gonna follow the guy. He's gonna show you where to take it.
I got your back, Jamie, don't worry.
Goodbye, Meter. You did. Here, kitty.
Okay, let's get going before the cat comes. Okay, so he's eating a, what's his name again?
Meter.
And obviously he's eating the head right now. See, he's eating our little friend. It's a really delicious treat. It's not every day you get such a delicious treat. Paige, is it every day he gets to have like fish heads and ground beef and hot dogs?
Chicken, deer, and turkey every other day.
Yeah, because he seems to like the fish heads.
Fish is his birthday gift every year.
And hot dogs, no?
We have over 20 cats here.
Oh.
Easy. All different, most different species.
Do most people come to this zoo for the cats?
Yes. Ah. Especially on Sundays when they get to see them eat chicken. Oh. Feathers, they eat the feathers, the feet, the wings, the head, everything.
Cool. Hey, it's now looking at the Smith album. We figured we'd put the little effigy on a record of the Smiths. You ever heard of the Smiths?
Yes. And he's enjoying it.
Yeah. We figured we'd give it something to look at.
Well, I say, you know that if somebody's really enjoyed their dinner when they licked their Smiths album clean.
This is probably a good promo for the Smiths, eh?
They love catnip. Surprising.
Oh, hang on. The catnip, eh?
Like catnip.
Oh, it's
and there goes your Smiths album.
Jeez, I hope it's okay for this jaguar to be eating plastic vinyl.
Yeah, he won't eat it. He'll just destroy it.
Okay.
For fun.
So look at that. It's like a little rabbit, eh? What is that thing? It's like a hare, a big funny hare?
That's a Patagonian cavy. Mm-hmm. The fourth largest rodent in the world.
So the largest rodent is?
Capybara.
Look at that. It's a kind of tall thing, isn't it? Okay, Mark, I want to make you an honorary member of the CBS Cadillac Bilshaw Safari Expedition team. And look what we've got. Capybara. There you go.
Awesome. Thank
there
you.
There you go.
Hey, Xanthi, eat one of the bananas.
No.
Go ahead, have a blueberry or two.
Are you allowed to keep one of the babies?
Yeah, can we take one, do you think?
I don't think Mom would be very happy if one went missing.
I think Mom might be relieved.
Don't bite my finger.
The CBS Safari Expedition team, right here on location at the Kilman Zoo. It's been a great day. We've stayed safe because we know what we're doing. We've got all of the equipment and gear and the pith helmets. Kids, if you ever come out to the wild outback, make sure you're wearing your pith helmets. Make sure you have some knowledge of wildlife. This is Cadillac Bill at Kilman Zoo. Back to you, Bill, in the studio.
All right. A little bit of nature, animals for
education?
You.
Education?
Yeah. And by the way, I got to say, that Kilman Zoo, they're really good sports.
Yeah.
Like, we called them up, and first of all, I said, hey, is it okay if I make this little man out of ground beef and hot dogs, give it to your big cats. They said, sure.
They're very, very accommodating.
The fact that they let us wander around with Janet carrying a rifle,
yes,
wearing a German helmet.
Yeah.
I mean, there were customers there.
Yeah, yeah.
And they had no problem with us wandering around with a rifle.
Yeah.
So they're good sports.
Yeah.
Those animals, by the way, they looked healthy and happy.
Yeah,
and,
they really did.
I'm not an expert on zoos, but those animals were taken care of.
You can tell when an animal is stressed out, they don't behave properly. And I've seen lots of leopards and jaguars behind bars and cages, and these were by far the happiest I've ever seen.
The happiest, yes. The happiest, absolutely. We are done for another episode, and let's get your amps on. The Creeping Bent Orchestra, the new Creeping Bent Orchestra, better and improved. We got Frankie Vomit on lead guitar. Hamilton, Till next time.